What a great night to be a Republican! We took the United States Senate tonight. We're looking real good in the New York State Senate tonight. We've got an outstanding slate of candidates, and you know what? The voters saw through the baloney the other side was putting out. They're smarter than the Democrats give them credit for. They know we've got the right candidates with the right message that's going to go and fight for them. They're not going to roll over to the New York City crowd. They're not going to roll over to Andrew Cuomo. They're not going to roll over to Barack Obama. They're going to go fight because they're Republicans, and that's what we do. And we work as a team, and all of you are part of that team. You're all part of the success tonight, and our leader of our team, our county executive, Maggie Brooks.
Thank you, Chairman. Wow, that is a tough act to follow. I think our chairman is excited. Let's give him a round of applause for his leadership. Chairman Bill Ryland. And you know what's different about this room versus the room across the street at the Hyatt? There's actually people in it. Thank you. This is a great night for Republicans, and once again, Monroe County is at the epicenter of the Republican wave that swept across this country tonight, and it's all because of the support of you in this room. So thank you very much. Time and time again, we go out and we talk to the voters about taxes and jobs and opportunity and quality of life, and we do it in a positive way. And this year, you know what? Mark Cassini and Rich Funke proved that positive messages will win the day. No question about it. I do want to thank all of our committee people who are here, all of the infrastructure in our party. We say this all the time. You're the heart and soul of what we do. We can't win races without you. And we celebrate time and time again because of what you do. I'm going to leave you with a thought. I went to the YMCA the other day, and on the bulletin board there was a little thing, and it said, if pro is the opposite of con, then progress is the opposite of Congress. Tonight, Monroe County voters chose progress in the United States House of Representatives. Congratulations, Mark and Rich Funke. I said in closing, but I just want to personally, before he takes the microphone in a few minutes, congratulate a longtime friend and former television colleague and now a government colleague, Rich Funke. I think this started with a dinner way back when, about a year ago. And I'm so proud. I'm so very, very proud of the race that he ran and the result that he got. So congratulations, Rich. And to all of our winners tonight, congratulations.
We offered the voters a choice in the 55th. We had an outstanding candidate, someone they knew, someone they'd known for years, someone who had fought for the community, helped with many charitable events, just a decent guy. You know what? Good guys do win. Rich Funke, the next senator for the 55th.
Thank County Executive Brooks and Chairman Ryland, Chairman Cook, and Chairman Corn in Monroe County, and Chairman Finch, and Chairman Koppel in Ontario County, all of the town leaders, all of the town supervisors, Senators Nozzolio, Young, and Robach, for standing by my side and convincing me to accept this extraordinary opportunity to serve the people of the 55th. I wouldn't be standing here without their support. And I want to thank also Senator Ted O'Brien for his longtime service to government, which I'm sure is going to continue. People who have been through this before have tried to explain to me what it's like to win your first election. I'd say it feels pretty good. I want to thank my wife, Pat, who when I came home last January and said, I'm thinking for running for the state Senate, I thank her for not saying, have you lost your mind completely? Instead, she said, I think you'll be great. And she has been by my side throughout this entire ordeal. I want to thank my daughter, Melissa, and my son-in-law, Dan, for coming up from North Carolina for tonight's celebration. They are among the many who have moved out of New York for a better opportunity and lower taxes. And if I can help New York State get on a better path, maybe I can get them to move back or at least send the grandchildren back. I also want to take a moment to thank my staff for putting on a great grassroots effort in this campaign, and our incredible volunteers from Irondequoit to Naples for their hard work and dedication day after day to get out all of the thank you notes that we sent out and get out the vote. And our Women for Funky group, who came to my defense. I want to thank them very much. I want to thank everybody who took a sign, everybody who mailed in a donation, made a call. Thank you for being part of our team. You know, it's one thing to win elections by talking a good game. Now it's time to deliver. It's time for us Republicans to deliver a unified message about creating smaller, more accountable, more affordable government in this country and in this state. It's time to end the partisan politics that hurts the very people we are trying to serve. It's time to work together. We need fresh ideas, and we need grassroots solutions to our problems if we're going to have any hope of making any progress in our community. And we can't move forward until we root out the corruption in Albany once and for all. Because what we do as elected officials is not about us. It is always about the people in the districts we represent. It is always about communicating with them and fighting for their interests first. And in the 55th Senate District, it'll be about jobs. It'll be about workforce development. It'll be about property and business tax relief. It'll be about getting our fair share of school aid and economic development aid. If Buffalo got $1 billion, by God, we better be next in line. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, we live in a beautiful part of the country. We have some of the best high schools in the nation. We have great universities, research hospitals, scientific brain power, a history of innovation, and an entrepreneurial spirit. As Bills coach Marv Levy used to say, where would you rather be than right here, right now? I want to thank you for trusting me to be your voice in Albany. Oh. Let's get to work. God bless.
The next gentleman, he knew what the odds were, but he believed in himself. And then we listened to him, and we believed in him, and the voters believed in him. And you know what? He's going to be the next representative in Washington representing Monroe County. He is in sync with the county. He's not out of touch like the other person. He's going to represent us well in Washington. The next representative to go to Washington on behalf of Monroe County, Mark Cassini.
I just want to tell you, I'm so very proud of the way this campaign was run. And I'm very proud of our campaign team. This was a true grassroots effort, and the chairman is right, Chairman Rylick is right. Not too many people gave us a chance, not too many people believed, but my family believed. They're here with me today. And I had some of the Republican leaders who believed. And I had a great campaign team who believed. And I want to thank every one of the kind people that I met at the doors. I am so very grateful, on balance, after visiting almost 12,000 homes, people were genuinely kind and gracious, even people who did not support me. And that is such a great thing. This is such a great community to have such kind and wonderful people, having some stranger knock on their door and willing to talk to them and welcome them. And so I want to say thank you to all those people that I met, and to the voters who believed. Nobody gave us a chance. And with several thousand absentee ballots, this race isn't over yet. Yeah. It went back and forth. And I think when all the absentee ballots have been counted, we'll have won the closest race in congressional history in Monroe County. And I also want to say to Mrs. Slaughter, I was very grateful that you ran an issues-oriented campaign, too. I was very proud that this was the type of campaign that voters would not be disappointed in, and I want to say thank you for that. I'm sorry I'm not conceding tonight, because there's ballots left to count, and I think at the end of the day, we're going to be on the right side. And last, most importantly, I'm going to pull you up. I'm sorry to embarrass you. I really want to thank my wife, Marianne, who was very key in this campaign. She was our, she filed all the FEC reports. She was the driver. She was kind of the campaign coordinator. She really motivated me when I would be tired. She'd, you know, kick me in the butt and say, "Mark, get out there and hit some more doors." And I just want to say thank you. I love you for all the support. Congratulations to all our candidates that were victorious tonight, and I hope to join you in the next week. Thank you. God bless everybody.
I feel confident Mark's going to do well. The race is within hundreds, and there are thousands of absentee ballots out. The next gentleman is going to be the newest representative going to Albany in the Assembly, representing a seat that I know well, the 134th Assembly District. He's going to represent those people well. He's got had a stellar career in the New York State Troopers, been appointed by the President of the United States Marshal. He knows the district. He understands the people, and he's going to represent them in Albany. He's going to send a message to Shelley Silver. The next Assemblyman from the 134th, Peter Lawrence.
It's hot up here. Listen. I don't want to make a speech, but I do want to give out a lot of thanks. And the first person I'm going to thank is Chairman Bill Rylick. We discussed me running for this position. He's been very supportive. When I needed pumping up, he pumped me up. When I needed direction, he gave me direction. Bill, thank you an awful lot. I appreciate it. Thank you, sir. Tom Cook of the Conservative Party, very important for his support. His party and his people have helped me along with this campaign. And thank you, Bill. Thank you to the Conservative Party. Steve Corin of the Independence Party, also thank you. Without your help, this victory may not have been possible. I'd also like to thank my wife, Tanya. Tanya, thank you. Tanya has wanted to stay in the background, but she's been very supportive. Whenever I needed help, she was always there. Again, Tanya, thank you. I love you. I'm used to winning teams. I was with the New York State Troopers for many years, and with no disrespect to any other police organization, I feel that we're the best police organization in the world. I volunteered time with the Brockport wrestling team. We won 5 national championships. But I want to tell you something. The team that we've got in the 134th Assembly District, from the towns of Greece, Eigen, and Parma, measures up to them in every way possible. I want to thank those people for all the help that they've given me, passing petitions, posting lawn signs, getting their neighbors out to vote, as well as voting for themselves. This victory would not be possible without them. And finally, I want to thank all of you folks for being here. I appreciate it. Thank you. And Bill, I want to tell you something. I ain't rolling over down in Albany.
No. I'm counting on you. This little guy put up a fight. Imagine a guy that size. Wow. Well, we had a number of victories, too. People that represent Monroe County, the 133rd Assembly District. Bill Nojay was successful tonight. In the 135th, we've got Mark Johns going back to Albany. In the 139th, we've got Steve Hawley. And then we talk about our great Senate team. Again, those folks are going to be in the majority, saving us from all the liberals from New York City. We've got Senator Nozzolio in the 54th District. Yeah. It was very helpful with the Senate campaigns this year, Senator Nozzolio and Senator Young. And in the 56th, we've got Senator Joe Robach in the 56th. Also successful tonight in the 59th, Pat Gallivan. In the 61st, Senator Ratzenhofer. We've got great representative in the New York State Senate. And in our own county legislature, we've got Brian Marinetti, who won in the 7th. Sean Delahaney won in the 11th district. In the 18th district, Dorothy Stick won big tonight. I gotta tell you, we won in Hamlin, we won in Parma, we won Diana Christodaro in Greece, we won in Clarkson, we won in Riga. There's nothing but wins here on the sheet tonight. Let's show the Democrats how to party. Enjoy yourself tonight. Thank you all for making this a successful night. And on to victory next year. Oh, wait a second. My good friend, my dear friend, how did I miss this? John Owens for Surrogate Court. Come on, John. He's done an outstanding job on the bench. He's going to continue that tradition in Surrogate Court. Thank you all tonight.